Good morning. Today we'll be doing the Liturgy of the Hours morning prayer for Wednesday, August 10th. Today we celebrate St. Lawrence, a deacon and martyr of our church. Let's have a moment of silence as we begin our prayer. God, come to my assistance.
Lord, make haste to help me.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Hallelujah.
Morning has broken like the first morning. Blackbird has spoken like the first bird.
My soul clings to you, my God, because I endure death by fire for your sake.
O God, you are my God. For you I long.
For you my soul is thirsting.
My body pines for you,
like a dry, weary land without water.
So I gaze on you
in the sanctuary
to see your strength. And your glory.
For your love is better than life. My lips will speak your praise. So I will bless you all my life. In your name I will lift up my hands. My soul shall be filled as with a banquet. My mouth shall praise you with joy.
On my bed I remember you. On you I muse through the night, for you have been my help. In the shadow of your wings I rejoice. My soul clings to you.
Your right hand holds me fast. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
My soul clings to you, my God, because I endured death by fire for your sake.
The Lord sent his angel to free me from the fire, and I escaped the flames unharmed.
Bless the Lord, all you works of the Lord. Praise and exalt him above all forever. Angels of the Lord, bless the Lord. You heavens, bless the Lord. All you waters above the heavens, bless the Lord. All you hosts of the Lord, bless the Lord. Sun and moon, bless the Lord. Stars and heaven, bless the Lord.
Every shower and dew, bless the Lord. All you winds, bless the Lord. Fire and heat, bless the Lord. Cold and chill, bless the Lord. Dew and rain, bless the Lord. Frost and chill, bless the Lord. Ice and snow, bless the Lord. Nights and days, bless the Lord. Light and darkness, bless the Lord. lightnings and clouds, bless the Lord.
Let the earth bless the Lord. Praise and exalt him above all forever. Mountains and hills, bless the Lord. Everything growing from the earth, bless the Lord. You springs, bless the Lord. Seas and rivers, bless the Lord. You dolphins and all water creatures, bless the Lord. All you birds of the air, bless the Lord. All you beasts, wild and tame, bless the Lord. You sons of men, bless the Lord.
O Israel, bless the Lord. Praise and exalt him above all forever. Priests of the Lord, bless the Lord. Servants of the Lord, bless the Lord. Spirits and souls of the just, bless the Lord. Holy men of humble heart, bless the Lord. Hananiah, Azariah, Mishael, bless the Lord. Praise and exalt him above all forever.
Let us bless the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Let us praise and exalt him above all forever. Blessed are you, Lord, in the firmament of heaven, praiseworthy and glorious and exalted above all forever.
The Lord sent his angel to free me from the fire, and I escaped the flames unharmed.
Blessed Lawrence Pray, I thank you, Lord, for permitting me to enter the gates of your kingdom.
Sing a new song to the Lord,
his praise in the assembly of the faithful.
Let Israel rejoice in its maker. Let Zion's son exalt in their king.
Let them praise his name with dancing,
and make music with timbrel and harp.
For the Lord takes delight in his people. He crowns the poor with salvation. Let the faithful rejoice in their glory. Shout for joy and take their rest. Let the praise of God be on their lips and a two-edged sword in their hand.
To deal out vengeance to the nations and punishment on all the peoples, to bind their kings in chains and their nobles in fetters of iron, to carry out the sentence preordained. This honor is for all his faithful.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Blessed Lawrence Pray, I thank you, Lord, for permitting me to enter the gates of your kingdom.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Praise be the God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and the God of all consolations. He comforts us in all our affliction and thus enables us to comfort those who are in trouble with the same consolation we have received from him. As we have shared much in the suffering of Christ, so through Christ do we share abundantly in his consolation. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Good morning. Our scripture reading today teaches us the value of having a merciful hearts and compassionate hearts. Showing mercy is impossible if we do not know what mercy is, along with praying and asking God for the grace to understand His mercy more deeply and exploring the resources to the church in praying the divine mercy. Having a merciful heart describes a person who has compassion for other people, someone willing to be kind to and forgive people who are in their power. The work of mercy had been traditionally divided into two categories: the corporal work of mercy, which concerned the material and physical need of other, while the second is the spiritual work of mercy, which concern the spiritual need of other. Just as we turn to Jesus, love incarnate, with our needs to love more completely, we turn to Him who is mercy itself, to cultivate our very hearts to be more merciful and compassionate. There are trying times that sometimes we felt the same way by being quickly offended, holding tightly to our grudges, by avoiding conflicts. But when it finds us, we are painfully slow to forgive. We need to remember that the Lord looks in us with compassion. He forgave us and saw that is how He asked us to forgive others as well. As we continue our prayer, we ask God to increase our devotion to His mercy, and in turn ask Him to help us reflect that mercy to the world. May our compassionate heart transform to be a loving heart.
The Lord is my strength, and I shall sing His praise.
The Lord is my strength, and I shall sing His praise.
The Lord is my Savior,
and I shall sing His praise.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
The Lord is my strength, and I shall sing His praise.
Do not be afraid, my son, for I am with you. If you should walk through the fire, the flames will not harm you, nor will the odor of burning cling to you.
Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel. He has come to His people and set them free.
He has raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of His servant David.
Through His holy prophets, He promised of old that He would save us from our enemies, from the hands of all who hate us.
He promised to show mercy to our fathers and to remember His holy covenant.
This was His oath He swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship Him without fear, holy and righteous in His sight, all the days of our life.
You, my child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare His way, to give His people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of their sins.
In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us to shine on those who dwell in darkness and the shadows of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Do not be afraid, my son, for I am with you. If you should walk through the fire, the flames will not harm you, nor will the odor of burning cling to you. Our Savior's faithfulness is mirrored in the fidelity of his witnesses, who shed their blood for the word of God. Let us praise him in remembrance of them. You redeemed us by your blood.
Your martyrs freely embraced death in bearing witness to the faith.
Give us the true freedom of the Spirit, O Lord.
Your martyrs professed their faith by shedding their blood.
Give us a faith, O Lord, that is constant and pure.
Your martyr follows in your footsteps by carrying the cross.
Help us to endure courageously the misfortunes of life.
Your martyr washed their garments in the blood of the Lamb.
Help us to avoid the weaknesses of the flesh and worldly allurements.
At this time, let's take a moment of silence to lift up our prayers and petitions to our Lord Jesus Christ. Dear Lord Jesus, we lift up to you our prayers and our petitions, together with the prayers and petitions of each and everyone who are praying with us this morning. We ask, dear Jesus, that you hear and answer each and every prayer as we say,
You redeemed us by your blood. Lord, remember us when you come into your kingdom and teach us how to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Let us pray. O God, giver of that ardor of love for you by which Saint Lawrence was outstandingly faithful in service and glorious in martyrdom, grant that we may love what he loved and put into practice what he taught. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you for praying with us.
We hope you can join us again tomorrow.
Same time,
same place,
same channel. Have a